Revenge Films.
My name is Amber. I work full-time at a certain company, but there was one thing that was troubling me. I kept finding the various items were being stolen from me at the office. At first, I thought somebody had made an honest mistake and taken my things by accident, but the next day, I once again found out that my personal belongings were gone. That being said, I had an idea who it might be. This woman in the same department as me named Karen. She had a habit of taking other people's things, and, besides myself, others have complained about their hair dryers being taken, or their period pads disappearing. But in every situation, she was quick to get away, and so we never caught her in the act, and there was nothing we could do about that. There was even this guy who had an umbrella stolen on a rainy day, so he confronted Karen.
It was you who took my umbrella, wasn't it?
But in return, Karen cried sexual harassment, and in the end, the male employee was the one who was punished. After that, even if the male colleagues were also victims, they also didn't have evidence and were no longer able to say anything. On top of that, Karen was very good at playing nice in front of our bosses and sucking up to them, so they all favored her. As proof of that, previously, when I had my umbrella taken by her, I tried to get help from the boss by telling him, Karen took my umbrella and has taken others as well, and was causing problems for all of us.
There's no way Karen would do such a thing. You must be mistaken.
It's not a mistake. I have a very distinct umbrella, and I saw Karen using it.
How can you be sure that she didn't have the same one?
He would always play devil's advocate to favor her. Even if I put a sticker with my name on it, it would be... innocent in front of them. Everyone was on board. Then a few days later in the office, I spoke loudly enough for Karen to hear. By the way, I received a tea that's apparently really effective for dieting. I've been drinking that lately. Ever since I started, I lost 5 pounds already.
I was just thinking these days that you've lost some weight. I didn't know that tea like that existed.
Yeah, I always put it in my water bottle and bring it with me. We made sure that she heard the entire conversation and went back to our normal day. Then, during my lunch break, I purposely left the water bottle in an unlocked locker. Just as expected, Karen sneakily made her move, so we all gathered in the shadows and waited. The next thing we know, Karen had spewed vinegar all over the locker room.
What is this? It's so sour!
She had tears in her eyes as she was coughing and gagging. That's when I stepped in.
What is this? This is just vinegar!
Exactly, this was pure, undiluted vinegar. As a prank, they had made a celebrity drink it and say it was tea. And when I saw them throw it right back up, the idea came to me.
I should be the one telling you that. That's my water bottle. What are you doing with it?
Excuse me? Can you not see the state I'm in? This is brand name dress and now it's covered in vinegar. You better pay for the dry cleaning.
What are you saying? I'm free to put whatever I want in my water bottle. And plus, you're in the state because you tried to drink what was in my water bottle without any permission whatsoever.
But thank you, because now we have proof.
Then I led Karen outside.
What? Where are you going? You need to do something about this vinegar all over my dress.
The rest of my colleagues were waiting outside, as well as my boss, whom they had called to the scene. Our boss's eyes opened wide.
What happened to you? What does that smell? Is that vinegar?
There was no denying the situation, so I once again explained how Karen had been stealing our umbrellas, among other things, as well as the current situation at hand. I admitted to putting vinegar in my water bottle, but that it was to provide evidence of her threat. Karen tried to deny it all.
This is a conspiracy! Everyone set this trap to frame me!
She was panicking and throwing a fit, but the boss also realized that all of this could have been avoided if they had just taken our complaint seriously, and this was a result of their negligence. This made it clear that Karen was intending to steal my water bottle and taking it home with her. So the boss pulled her into the office to ask further questions, and they launched an investigation. They found out that not only was she stealing other employees' personal belongings, but that she was also going into the company storage room and taking various items from there too. On top of that, when they investigated into her phone, they were shocked to find that she was reselling those items through a marketplace app. Of course, Karen was fired. They were able to find all of the items that were stolen and sold through the app, and she was sued for the combined value. The other colleagues and I also collected the cost of our stolen items in cash, and the bosses who were fooled by her sweet behavior and ignored our complaints were punished with a 3-month salary deduction. Karen was apparently married, but her husband and in-laws found out about the entire situation because of the amount of money that she had to pay. When they went into the app, they found out that there were items from her husband's family that were also up for sale. In particular, there were a lot of things belonging to her mother-in-law, and she had sold necklaces and diamonds on them, as well as brand-named items and other expensive valuables. The mother-in-law was enraged and kicked her out of the house and the family.
Get out of here, you thief! And you're getting a divorce from my son immediately!
Karen was forced to flee. Her husband had a word.
There must be something wrong with you to steal other people's belongings and sell them just to have a little pocket money. I can't live with you anymore. We're getting a divorce, and you're no longer welcome in this house.
Karen was sued not only by the company, but also by her husband and his family for the things she had stolen for bringing shame to the family. Karen tried to put the blame on me.
This is all your fault because of you. I'm losing everything. This is all your fault, so obviously you better be paying for all of these fees.
She tried, but there is no way that logic would ever pass anyway. If she ever tried to come to my house, I wouldn't hesitate to call the cops on her. Before that could happen, Karen's parents came out of the suburbs to deeply apologize to everyone involved, and they promised to make sure that she pays back everybody for everything she owed. Karen was kicked out of the house and had nowhere to go, and her parents forcibly dragged her back with them. I guess the one saving grace was that she didn't have any kids. They were definitely gonna get bullied for having a thief as a mother. Once Karen was gone, the disappearing items came to an immediate halt, and everybody was able to focus on their work. Even the CEO came to our office to apologize.
How was today's video? If you enjoyed it, please subscribe, like, and leave a comment. Stay tuned for more.